Hi, welcome to Barney Tech Channel. Here we are going to see about earth fault detecting by using source injection method. Normally they use low frequency source. In some case DC source is also used. Whatever may be the source, the normal working will be like this. Normally the generator rotor is connected with the exciter. Next we will have two very high resistor connected with series, and one of the resistor is connected with parallel to exciter, and other end of the other resistor is grounded. Next block is source. The source is connected with these two high resistance, and the source voltage is connected with relay for measuring, and the circuit current is also connected to relay for measurement. By using simple formula mo is equal to v by i, the relay easily find the resistor of the rotor. Under normal running condition, the apply voltage will be appear on this two point. We consider it as a V1 voltage, and in case the voltage across the resistor only appear on the rotor, which will be lesser and will not make any side effect on the rotor function. And also the current flow will be over two high resistor, so the mo value will be very high. Under fault condition, we will see how it is going to work. Let us consider the fault on rotor winding. Due to this fault, there will be a closed path on the source through earth path. We know that the current flow on a low resistor path, so the current will start to flow through winding to ground and avoid this high resistor path. Now the current flow will be high and the relay start to calculate the mo value. Depend on the relay setting, it will give trip. This is how the rotor earth fault relay working. In real time I have seen one fault condition I will share with you all. During normal running condition, the value of ohm is around 999 kilo ohms on rotor protection relay. One time the relay shows 180 kilo ohms. It was found that the high dust on rotor brush. Due to this dust, the resistor value is reduced. After cleaning the rotor brush, then the resistor become normal. For testing this protection, it is very simple. Just we need to have a variable resistor connected to the resistor to this TB and stimulate the low resistor value. Depend on the setting, it will give alarm and trip. If you don't have any resistor, you can use just a loop wire for checking the tripping. By this we came to the end of the section. On next section, I like to make a generator capability curve. We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech Channel. Thank you for watching this video.